So he's like, white, black soldiers. Flash Freeze not coming in. It's possible I might want Wall of Faith here. Is there any particular card that is not good? No, my guys are all pretty good against his crappy guys. I think I'm alright for now. Sand's pretty sick. The last hand might have been sweeter because they're like a Mind Spring and an Elemental, but this hand definitely has a better curve. Opponent's probably going to have more than 3 land in play on turn 10 this game, but then again, so are we. Dirty Skeletons. Not too impressive here. I'm going to play a Stormfront Pegasus. Get the Flying Beatdown going. There's our Mind Spring. Might Unholy Strength with Dirty Skeletons. Assembled Machine. I remember when I first started playing, I wasn't sure if you could Holy and Unholy Strength the same guy. And I thought you could, but it seemed wrong somehow. Be pretty good right here. It'd be like build your own Cuddle Troll. Might as well play this guy. Veteran Earthsmith's not likely to get through for damage anyway, so might as well play the more expensive guy. He's definitely better than Horn Turtle because he, you know, will fly over his Dredge Skeletons. This guy's all defense all the time. Not really much to see here. Although I definitely should have played Horn Turtle there. I'm not sure why I played that guy. Just kind of clicked on him. That was kind of stupid. The reason I play Horn Turtle is because if I draw a fourth land, I could play Armorsmith and leave Essence Scatter up. Hopefully it doesn't have like a Sarah Angel this turn. I haven't seen anything of the like though. Just nothing? No, it's got to have something, right? No, I guess not. Get in with my Griffin Sentinel and see what the deal is. See, this is why that mistake was bad, because now if I play Horn Turtle, leave encounter right now. So, is it going to Divine Verdict my guy? I think that's fine. I'm just going to pass. No reason to get Mind Shattered, Liliana Vest, Baneslayer Angel, etc., etc. So you have Negate and Essence Scatter. With their powers combined, it's like a counterspell. Child of Light, that is acceptable. More spells. Or not? I don't know. Yeah, we'll ponder. Wouldn't mind trying to see an island here. Air Elemental cancel passives. It's good, but if I do that, I'm not drawing blue mana for a long time, and I've got a lot of gas in my hand. Yeah, I'll shuffle. See? Blessed. Still can't really attack me here. Communicate. There's one card in his hand. Yeah, I think that's okay. That's fine. He's going to do a little bit of damage. I'll redraw my guy, replay. And that's about it. Yeah. I think he's in a pretty big hole at this point. Well, Mind Spring doesn't have great synergy with all these counters. I guess I'll just have to pick a turn where I, you know, tap out and then hopefully not have to tap out ever again. Holy Strength is Dredge Skeletons. That's also fine. He's going to get a little damage in right now, but Horn Turtle should put a stop to those shenanigans soon enough. This deck is a few cards that aren't too great. either that or his unholy strength was pre-boarded against my ice cage. Yeah, that's it. Still stopping on the draw step just in case he wants to play Vindiling Click or something. Ooh. Look, it's a threat I don't have to tap out for. Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, I will let him cast as many bad grizzly bears, well, grizzly bears as he wants. I think I'm going to wait on the Gargoyle Castle. I want to cast a Mindspring. So, I want to be able to cast Mindspring and leave up Essence Scatter slash Negate, so I don't really want to sack land quite yet. Four. This is probably not happening. So this cancel is in order. Because that way I can still leave up Scatter next turn. And if the Negate in hand, it's not like you can do anything about it. Let's draw four cards. Oh, look at that. I found an island. Yeah, this looks pretty over, I think. Got a passive, an ice cage, a negate, and a scatter. So I'm like four cards up. He has three cards in hand, so... Well, two cards in hand. Yeah, he still can't really get in very well. Nah, he begs to differ. He wants to, like, safe passage or something. Alright. Or either he's throwing away two guys for, like, 5 points of damage. Works for me. I'm going low enough that I think I want to negate that. If I had a little few more life, I wouldn't. But I've already traded a bunch of life for cards so far, so can't keep doing it. Card to draw. Don't really want to bash at this point. Now I wish I had my essence scatter or cancel back for my essence scatter, but it was still fine. What is this attack? Is this a Divine Verdict attack? I guess I'm not like, completely destroying him here, but still getting a guy for free. Yeah, I'll trade soldiers. He doesn't have something. This is like a pretty bad attack. A Glorious Charge. Let's see. No, that would be pretty bad for me if I didn't have safe passage. Kill all my guys. Why is he casting safe passage? None of his guys died to any of my creatures. That's pretty funny. Alright. He could have had a safe passage in his hand for free, but I guess he decided to decline that generous offer. Ooh, Wall of Frost. And I can activate Gargoyle Castle. And I can't leave counter right up, so I might as well keep a land in my hand in case of mind rot. There's no cards in hand. I feel fine getting in like this. My opponent's drawing a little slim here. Creatures want help, only spells. That is still fine. I don't save my essence scatter or something like Captain of the Watch. Time to unleash the Gargoyle. Ooh, an air elemental. Alright, I have two of those guys. Splits him to 10. Yeah, this kills him next turn. I think speeding up the clock by a turn is worth risking planar collapse or whatever. Planar cleansing. And sure, let's ice cage your guy. Just in case. Not too worried about Mind Rot anymore, because if he draws Mind Rot, then he's dead. And it looks like he's dead. All right. Off to round two.